Now, adjust the volume control so that the sound can be heard in all parts of the room.
This is the Protect Your Assets podcast.
You get the idea? Bring me
a dream. It's on the internet.
Make him the cutest that I've ever seen.
Go on.
Give him two lips.
Like it's like no cheese I've ever tasted.
And tell him that his lonesome.
Here's the Sandman. Over
Sandman. Good morning. I'm David Hollander, your host, and today I will be your drill sergeant. As this entire month, we've rolled out our version of a retirement boot camp.
Hoo-ah!
We've done our best to help you jumpstart your New Year's resolutions to pay down your mortgage, save more money, and of course, pay less in taxes. For those of you just joining us for the first time, well, welcome. I almost got blown away last night. I don't know about you, but people around here, we're here. We're broadcasting. It's amazing. The wind tried to take us out last night, but we're here. Everything's working. I'm the Sandman. My listeners around here, they call me that because I help them sleep well at night by answering their most troubled legal or financial questions each week right here. You remember Humpty Dumpty? Well, these past few weeks, hate to say I called it, but I've been saying that, remember when Humpty Dumpty fell off the wall and now you're probably wondering, what should I do? Well, the market segment, which is coming up next, I'm going to get into what's going on right now, but I thought this would be the perfect week to go over some bad investment choices for 2022. And where you should be investing your 401k or other accounts this year, because volatility has definitely picked up. And what goes up must come down. So do yourself a favor and listen closely to the entire show today as I unveil some smart money moves for 2022 as you try and save more. It's a brand new year. Some big changes are here. The winds are blowing. So now's the time to make some changes. Take a big gulp of that ritual coffee. Get a pad of paper and a pen and get ready to become clear on your mission today, soldier, because it's going to be a great show. Now let's get started. Well, once again, there was no clear catalyst for the market rolling over this week. The Dow Jones was off 4.6% for the week. Haven't seen that for some time. Year-to-date is down 5.7%. S&P off 5.7% for the week, down 7.7% for the year. NASDAQ, off 7.6% for the week. We officially went into correction territory. Year to date, NASDAQ's off 12. More about that in a minute. And the 10-year pulled off a little bit. It got a little over 180 and closed at 1.76%. Once again, I keep telling you, oil, price of oil at $84.25 for the week. Oil was up. You heard me. Up 6.8%. Year to date, oil is up 12%. Talk about diversification. So for the third week in a row, there was some ugly price action in the market as an early effort to try a rally this week faded, and stocks, well, they fell into the horizon and finished near lows, of course. And as far as reasons, which is what I got a lot of questions this week, no shortage of them. And that's okay when this stuff starts to happen. I know. What did he say again? Well, let's talk about it. This is officially the market segment. Yes, there were some negative headlines. Specifically, the Senate antitrust bill on technology and chatter about how the Fed might abruptly stop quantitative easing next week. Or I like this one, 50 basis point raise on March 15th. This is what's talking about right now. But there is only one reason stocks are falling. Ready? The Fed, for 14 years, has practiced a policy of gradual change and a strategy of communicating that ensured there was no surprises. Well, for whatever reason, call it inflation, call it politics, some of you will call it something else, the Fed has abandoned that practice, and that's hitting the most expensive part of the market. What am I talking about? High PE tech. This also happens to be the biggest part of the market and the most overowned. So what's going on right now is the plumbing is getting clogged up and Roto-Rooter's coming through. And this is what brought the stocks under pressure. And that pressure is not going to end. You heard me this morning. It's not going to end until the Fed moves back towards providing more gradual guidance and consistent messaging about what they're going to do. Now, I think the Fed's going to do this eventually because they see what's happening to the market right now. And as the declines continue, it's going to hopefully wake them up. But let me tell you this. First of all, I don't want you to fear the March rate hike. I agree. I think they're going to do it. But I don't think that a tighter policy is going to bring about, listen to me closely, the next economic or stock market recession. I don't see that word yet. Said correction, you heard me, but not recession. And that's because the run-up to this first hike is accompanied usually by a rocky patch, which is what you're in right now. And during the last four times we've seen this, 1994, which is when I started in the business, 1999, 2004, 2015, I've had the general luck to be through all these. The median move in the S&P 500 in the 3 months following the first rate hike was down 1.6%. But get this, 6 months out from that first raise, the median gain for the S&P 500 was 7.4%. So it shows you it takes time for the market to adjust to what's going on. Now, I'm not saying right now that inflation is not running too hot, because it is. And Fed tightening cycles are usually borne by this sort of expansion. And that should be the case here in 2022. In all but one, remember the tech bubble pop in 2000? Fed cycles in the last 40 years, the stock market rose double digits over the 2 years following the first rate hike. So I think we are still ways away from the Fed ruining the Tea Party. And so I think that overall we're looking pretty good. Now, why do I say that? How do you know, Dave? Well, you got to look at the economy. And this last week we had the Philly Fed. I'm not talking about Philly cheesesteak. I'm not talking about cream cheese, even though I like both those things in moderation, because I'm only allowed to do that in moderation. Because people need me around. Anyway, I'm sorry, I just digressed. It's the chaga this morning. Anyway, the Philly Fed this week, which shows general business activity going on, jumped by almost 8 points. We had a solid reading in January of 23.2, and new orders rose another 4.2 points for a respectable 17.9. All that means is, bottom line, that was a solid print. And right now that manufacturing is growing. It's strong. It's a good number. It's a It's all we can look at is what's going on, these tests. So what now? I hear you. What do I do now, Dave? Well, this 6% pullback in the S&P 500 is underpinned by what? What's causing this? It's the tech sector. This was the largest source of gains for that index last year because the tech right now is the largest weight in the S&P 500. And tech is the hardest hit asset when rates rise. I've said this over and over and over again. If you go back and listen to all the market segments so far this year, I've warned you about this. So what do you do? Value. Value continues to outperform growth, and I like that. And I continue to recommend an overweight allocation to value because I think that cyclical asset classes and sectors are going to benefit from the second wind that's coming. It's out there. You can see the wind. I see the trees right now. They're moving around. The winds are changing. And when you have moderate inflation, when the supply chain bottleneck starts to clear and you have these improving employment conditions, then I like all that. But there's more. And I want you to listen to the rest of the show today because I have more information for you on how you need to invest your money this year as interest rates rise. So where do you put it? When I come back, I'm going to share it with you. You're listening to The Sandman on the Protect Your Assets Radio Network. We'll be right back.
You can ask The Sandman questions and hear this show Protect Your Assets hands-free anytime on your Amazon Echo smart speaker. Just say, Alexa, ask Protect Your Assets to play the latest podcast. Find out more at libertygroupllc.com/voice.
Now, back to Protect Your Assets with David Hollander, The Sandman.
Welcome back. I'm David Hollander, also known as The Sandman. And our goal this entire month has been to help our listeners live a more productive, less stressed life when it comes to your money, taxes, and estate planning needs. Because this entire month, January, we've taken this hour each week to help you get into financial shape for 2022. Because I'm sure as part of your New Year's resolution, you were thinking about, gosh, I'd like to do this or I'd like to do that. I'd like to go here or there or save more or whatever. It involves money. And so if I can give you a couple tips to show you how to save more money, then maybe your dreams will come true. So this is episode number 4 of our retirement boot camp series. And if you missed any of our great content we put together for you, then feel free to go pull down a podcast. And I'm not sure where you get your podcasts. I use Spotify. Maybe you use iTunes or Google. You can just type in this. Type in Protect Your Assets. And that'll pull up a whole host of market segments. So you can see what I've been talking about for weeks and what's happening right now and where I said things were going. It's all there for you. Just go find it. And if you missed any of the shows, lots of good basic training that we threw out there this week and last week and the week before that, then it's right there for you. So if you like it, then please tell a friend because I would appreciate that. So on today's show, we're going to take a peek into our crystal ball and share with you where you should invest in 2022. And what do you need to watch out for? So let's start out with some landmines, shall we, soldier? Because they're out there and you don't want to step on one of those. And the first one, which I see every week, this never ends, is sitting on too much cash that pays you nothing. And right now I know it feels good, right? You're feeling smart, like, ooh, I did great. Because the NASDAQ went off 12% this week, down, and I'm lost nothing. Right? Wrong. If you have money in the bank, then right now a large portion of your cash that's sitting in cash paying you nothing is not good. You should be looking at least some sort of fixed income that pays some fixed amount of interest on that. Now, like what, Dave? What could I look at that's still safe? Well, U.S. Treasuries. Those are backed by the full faith and credit of the U.S. government, and they'll pay you something. I know it's not a lot, but it's something. And get this, right now, a lot of people are holding cash. Balances in money market funds hit this number, get this, $353 billion over the past 3 years. That was a 55% increase, according to analysis from DataTrek. Deposits in U.S. banks also increased 11% during this period. Now, I know, I got the calls, they were coming in. Oh, I want to go to cash now. Oh, the market's going to go down. I got to get out of it. Well, when are you going to get back in? You have to make two decisions correctly. It's impossible. It's impossible. I find a lot of times people feel that if they can get some kind of yield on cash versus a long-term bond, cash feels a little better. But think about this. If you do that, you're going to give up higher returns. How? Let me give you another example. Last year, arguably a very good equity market. Yes. Tough for bonds. A lot of bonds were negative or flat or down. Well, guess what? The Bloomberg U.S. High Yield Corporate Index. This is a index of approximately 17,000 corporate bonds. Well, that returned 5.28%. It's not bad. Pretty good. Money market funds paid barely 0.05%. And right now, those rates are so low that it's hard to make any money on your money. So what do? Stuff money in your mattress? Buy gold? More on that later. You got to think about inflation. Inflation's running hot right now. And inflation is basically going to eat away at your money if you're not making 3+% return on your money. So you've got to get some more money on there. And if you're 65 years old right now or older and you want income right now, then we have something that's paying 5.51%. And it's insured. You heard me right, 5.51%, and it's insured. Now, in a minute, I'm going to let you know how to find out more about that. Be patient. Next, what else should you be doing right now? What's another landmine? Even right now, even though some of your stocks have gone down, doesn't matter. Here's what I want you to do. You need to rebalance, and you need to do that somewhat regularly, especially now because the Fed is about to get active. March 15th is when I think they're going to raise, maybe 25, maybe 50. I don't know, but I'm pretty sure they're going to do something. And markets are not static. So you have to readjust now, right now, before the game tonight, to make sure that your investments are not off course. And I'm going to tell you right now, what worked last year and the year before that, it's not going to work this year. Why? Because rates are going to rise this year. It's a different environment. And as rates rise, those companies that borrow money usually have very high price-to-earnings ratios, PE ratios. And as rates rise, there's something called compression. When you put pressure on something, what happens? You got it.
I've lost my mojo!
Yep, it pops! So let's say you set up your portfolio as a 60-40 allocation. 60 at stocks, 40 at bonds. And as we know, last year, stocks did pretty well. Even if you look at it today, even if you're down a little, come on, from a year and a couple of weeks ago, you should be happy. If you're not, fire your person. Anyway, with your positive returns on your portfolio, you may be sitting on roughly 75% stocks now and 25% bonds. We see this all the time. Right now is the time to hit the rebalance button, where you sell off a bit of your stock gains and put that money elsewhere, like in value or cyclicals, like I talked about in the market segment. Because if you do that, it's highly likely that your returns over the longer term will be pretty strong. And so you're going to need to have buckets of money where you have things that are allocated 60-40. Because over time, those return pretty decent, healthy returns. 5-6%. It's typical. So I recommend that you rebalance that portfolio at least once a year. And another good rule of thumb is to look at your allocation. Because if they're off, say, more than 5 to 10%, then guess what? You hit the button again. The best part about doing this is your portfolio is telling you, it's screaming at you that part of it has underperformed. It's not doing what it should do. It's gotten beaten up. And so now's the time where you pull the trigger and it forces you to buy low and sell high, which is a good way to protect yourself. And it's a good way to make sure that when this stuff starts to happen, you're diversified and you're in a better place. Now, one thing I want to share with you today, because we had someone walk in yesterday, good morning, Brett, is Prop 19. Have you heard about this? Well, it's not good. If you have rental properties or you have properties you're trying to leave to your kids, there's this Proposition 19 out there, which is going to tax you more. What should you do? Well, do you have a plan that helps you save more money each and every month? No? Well, hope is not a strategy. If you haven't looked at this for a while, or you're not sure about how this new law, this Prop 19, will affect you, then you probably need some help. Now, in my office, you know, we have attorneys. Yes, I'm an attorney. We have CPAs and tax professionals, certified financial planners, all working together as a team to protect you. We can show you what you need to look out for, where your weaknesses are, and how to keep the income coming in when you're under attack, like right now. Get your confidence back with our exclusive on-track retirement review. Now, as part of your on-track retirement review, we're going to look at all of your assets right now under our microscope to see how you can maximize your income and protect what you've earned so far. After all, this show's called Protect Your Assets. So like I mentioned earlier, remember that interest rate I talked about earlier, over 5% if you're 65 or older? If you want to earn more interest right now, then take action. Pick up the phone, soldier. Call this number, 866-PROTECT. Brett is sitting on the phone right now waiting to talk to you. I can see him. Give him something to do. 866-PROTECT. Because it's your money. Find out how to protect it. Don't keep watching it go down. 866-PROTECT right now. Coming up next on Protect Your Assets, it's time for our popular They Say segment, where they say that you should have technology in your portfolio. Is that a good idea right now? So much more to come. You're listening to The Sandman on the Protect Your Assets Radio Network. We'll be right back.
Ziggy played guitar, jamming good.
You can ask the Sandman questions and hear this show protect your assets hands-free anytime on your Amazon Echo smart speaker. Just say, Alexa, ask Protect Your Assets to play the latest podcast. Find out more at libertygroupllc.com/voice.
Now back to Protect Your Assets with David Hollander, the Sandman.
Welcome back. I'm David Hollander, also known as the Sandman. And our goal is to help all of our listeners live a more productive, less stressed out life when it comes to their money. And so this entire month, we've taken this hour each week to help you get into financial shape for 2022. And this is our fourth episode of the Retirement Boot Camp series. And if you missed any of it, then feel free to check out our podcast. Now it's time for one of our fan favorite parts of the show, our They Say segment, where we debunk common myths, half-truths, and sometimes just bad advice that they say.
Who are they? What do they know that I don't? And what are they saying this week? There's only one man with all the answers, and here he is, David Hollander, the Sandman.
So here's one they say. They say that you should have technology in your portfolio. Is that always true? And if so, to what extent? Well, I think right now that really depends on what kind you have. And I'll tell you why. Recently, a gentleman by the name of Tim, he called us. Now, Tim has worked at Netflix for 10 years. And he's accumulated, get this, over $5 million of Netflix stock. Well, that was before Thursday night. It's about, or it was about, 90% of his account, and he wanted to know if that was a really good idea. Well, we immediately told him that having too much in any one stock in your portfolio, it's not a good idea, because you never know what can happen, and stocks move much more rapidly than, say, a diversified portfolio, especially when you own just one stock. So we explained to him the idea of diversifying his holdings into different asset classes that met his risk tolerance and his time horizon for retirement. And the wild swings that we saw the first few weeks here in January, particularly again when Netflix announced earnings last Thursday night. And when you have a tech stock that's trading at 100 PE, you heard me right, 100 price to earnings ratio, sometimes even greater. I've seen some of these electronic automobile, whatever manufacturers trading over 100 times PE. Well, guess what? Those can easily drop to 50 times PE. And that's still twice what the S&P 500 is trading at. You heard me. So lately, we've seen high growth, high PE tech stocks get hurt pretty badly, drop over 50%. And that's because those stocks were at values that were highest ever. And you're not going to see what we call value investors step in and buy those names until they become a good value, where the stocks will defend that position. So when you ask me the question right now, is there more room to fall on these high PE tech stocks? The answer is yes. So get out of them. And know this, which I've been saying for weeks, go back and listen to the market segments. I said that as rates rise, higher technology PE stocks would drop in price, period, end of story. So if you must own tech, which I'm not saying is a bad idea, depending on what type of tech, then I'd say for some of your portfolio, if you can tolerate the volatility and the time horizon again, stick with them at least 10 years. You don't need to live off of them. Then stick with quality. Now, as my mother brought me up to understand, there's a difference in definition of the term quality. So let me give you the crib sheet on that. Quality right now in the tech sector consists of lower price to earning stocks with solid businesses, solid cash flow, and a good product line. What am I talking about? Super cap tech like Apple, Microsoft, Oracle, Cisco. Because right now you've got Congress, the Senate is putting through antitrust legislation on some of these companies, and they're not done. So be careful. What else should you own right now? Value, cyclicals, consumer staples, and utilities. What about gold?
I love gold.
I don't. Gold does not belong in your portfolio right now. And even if it did, what form should you own it in? I'm going to talk about that next. But right now, how many of you are wondering about your retirement? Because if you're like Tim, remember Tim who worked at Netflix? I just talked about him. If you're like Tim, chances are you have a lot of your company's stock just sitting there. And if Tim hadn't called us weeks ago, he would have lost $1.2 million. Because Tim made that phone call, he's planning his retirement later this year with the income he's now created from all that stock. Yes, he had to pay some taxes. But best of all, before he made those sales, he was informed on how's the best way to pay the tax on his stock options with the least amount of pain, because our team of financial planners and CPAs who work together at the same table, they showed him in writing how to exit out of his stock options so he could see the benefit of doing it before he did it. Now, Tim really appreciated this approach because his financial advisor he used to be with didn't have a CPA in their office. And the CPA that he was using couldn't financially model his stock options. They just told him to sell them as he got them. Wrong. Think about it. Tim just picked up the phone, called us, and now Tim's leaving his job in March. And he's going to collect his bonus. And then he's down the road. Easy. So whether you're like Tim, or whether you have a little less or you have a little more, pick up the phone and give us a call for a complimentary 15-minute coaching call to possibly change the next 30 years of your life. Think about it. Stop worrying about money. We have the best coffee. In fact, we are the only ritual distributor in the East Bay. So come over here, get some great coffee, free parking, great staff who care about you, and best of all, yes, we're right here. We're local. Plus, if you want to meet us virtually, well, guess what? We can arrange that too. So give us a call right now to find out how we can help you. Call this number, 866-PROTECT. That's 866-PROTECT. To create a safe and secure retirement. It's your money. Find out how to get more. Dial 866-PROTECT. Now it's time for a quick break. But when I come back, should you own gold? And if you do, what form should it be in? You don't want to miss this one because I promise you, you're going to learn something. It pays to keep it tuned right here. We'll be right back.
You can ask the Sandman questions and hear this show protect your assets hands-free anytime on your Amazon Echo smart speaker. Just say, Alexa, ask Protect Your Assets to play the latest podcast. Find out more at libertygroupllc.com/voice. Now, back to Protect Your Assets with David Hollander, the Sandman.
We're back. I'm David Hollander, and you're listening to Protect Your Assets this morning. on the Protect Your Assets Radio Network. And isn't that such an appropriate name right now? Protecting your portfolio as the markets are bouncing all around. We found the number one key to financial success in retirement is how to control volatility. Because big swings up and down in your portfolio can cause you to run out of money when you need it the most to live on, and that's not good. So when you enter retirement, you stop adding money to your investments, and you do the opposite. You have to start taking money out each month to live on. And this increases the risk on, and stress, I'd call it, on your portfolio, and can actually cause you to spend less in retirement because you get scared. So our job is to help our clients increase the certainty with their money so they can spend more even when the next bear market strikes. All right, well, I know red and gold tonight is the right place to be. But the question is, should you own gold in your portfolio? And if so, what form?
Danger's my middle name.
Now consider this. As interest rates rise, so does the yield on bonds typically. Now when that happens, gold is not the place to be. Because money leaves these hard assets and chases things like treasuries. Likewise, when the dollar is strong, like it is now, or it's growing, that also hurts gold. So currently, I am neutral gold. I need to see interest rates stabilize before I would turn bullish on gold. It's true, gold recently broke through multi-month highs, but I want to see it break $1,880 an ounce and stay there for me to become interested. All right, there's my answer. Now, that being said, if I were to buy gold right now, what form should I buy it in? This is a great question. And by the way, this question stumped 7 lawyers on my listserv this week. So you're not uneducated, put it that way, because 7 educated people couldn't answer this question. Consider this. If you buy physical gold, and I know who you are and why you do that, I get it. Your analog, you need to have a certificate of ownership that backs up the serial number on that coin, or coins if you have multiple in your safe. These papers are necessary when your beneficiary inherits those coins. If you hold or own gold bars, then I want you to pay attention. After 9/11, if you don't have proof of ownership papers to support that you own and you're the owner of those gold bars, then we're going to have to go to probate for your beneficiary and get a court order which says that your beneficiary has the right to sell that asset. Did you hear what I just said? As you know, we are attorneys. That's why I'm a little different than a lot of people here on the air, because I'm actually an attorney. We can help you maneuver through the courts to protect your loved ones and make sure they receive what you want when you want. A simpler way to do this would be to own an ETF, an exchange-traded fund that is exclusively gold in your portfolio, and that way it's easy to buy and sell and trade. But I know you don't like digital. You want the physical. I get it. And that's okay. Just realize there could be some problems if that's you. Now, here's what I want you to do. I want you to take a deep breath in your nose. Exhale through your mouth. And picture a day when you don't have to worry about money, taxes, or how you can pass your assets on to your loved ones ever again. Because you got it taken care of. Picture a day when you're standing in your kitchen. Your family is all around you, and your daughter asks you if you want garlic or regular mashed potatoes. You say garlic, honey, and then realize you don't have to go back to work on Monday Picture a day when you can relax, travel, and do all the things you've always wanted to do. It all starts with the conversation. Pick up the phone right now. Dial this number, 866-PROTECT. If you're tired of the same old story, you don't feel like you're going anywhere, you don't know how much you can spend each month and not run out of money, call this number, 866-PROTECT, and talk to my team. Set up a complimentary appointment where we'll make sure you have a great cup of coffee, some healthy food, and a great conversation. 866-PROTECT. Want to give a big thanks to the Protect Your Assets team for putting together a fantastic show today. Fantastic boot camp.
Hoo-ah!
This entire month. Thank you. It's been a lot of fun. Executive producer and network manager Kevin Renfer. And all my fabulous producers back there doing all the heavy lifting. Sean, Phil, and Brett. Because without my team, I'm just another pretty voice on the radio. You've been listening to the Protect Your Assets Show. I am David Hollander, the Sandman. Go out and make the rest of your life the best of your life.
All calls have been screened. Callers should not expect their conversations with David Hollander on the radio or with staff to be held in confidence. And that legal information provided on the air is not intended to be a substitute for callers hiring their own lawyers to advise them about personal legal matters. Proper advice depends on complete analysis of all the facts and circumstances. The information given on this program is in the nature of general financial comment and cannot be relied upon as pertaining to your specific financial situation. California Life Agent number 0B48569. Listeners should consult their own financial advisor or conduct their own due diligence before making any financial decisions. The preceding program was paid for by Liberty Group, LLC. The views and the opinions of the host do not represent those of this station or its ownership. You're listening to the Protect Your Assets Radio Network.